Gary from Gary's Guitar Lessons here, and today I'm going to be going through static chord movements. The idea here is when we have one chord for a long time, how do we create movement without actually changing the chord? These will often be thought of as like riffs or licks to go around with it. I'm going to be combining two today, country and Motown, because they use similar techniques to kind of create some movement within the chord. All right, so my first example is going to be my kind of country style. Now here, I'm going to be going through three different chords, one in an open shape, and then the other two is as kind of like a bar chord version, so it's movable to any chord. Okay, so first is E. I'm going to be hitting my open sixth string, and then I'm going to be using my two fingers over here, my second finger and my third finger, to pluck the third string. My second finger is going to be on the third string, and my third finger is going to be on the second string. Play both of those open, and I'm going to be hammering on my first finger on the third string, first fret. Now, if the finger picking is giving you a hard time, you can easily pick that as well. Just be sure you're only picking just the third and the second string. All right, now I'm going to be hitting that bass note again, or kind of the root note of the chord. Again, since this is E, it's going to be that sixth string open. Then I'm going to be barring my first finger on the second fret on those same two strings, the third string and the second string, second fret. And that's kind of the idea of the lick. So this chord over here, what I'm doing is when I'm putting my first finger on the second fret on both the third and second string is going to be almost like a little bit of an A triad. But since my bass note is still E, it's just kind of slightly moving to A without really taking us off the E chord. So you can kind of play that over an E chord for a long period of time. All right, now to move this, we're going to be thinking of our six string bar chord. My first fingers, you know, since I'm on A, my first finger is going to be on the sixth string, fifth fret. There's my major bar chord, and I'm going to be playing my first finger on the fifth fret, sixth string, plucking just that note for my bass note. Then my first finger is going to be barred on the fifth fret, both on the third string and the second string, and I'm going to be hammering my second finger on the third string, sixth fret. I'm going to be hitting that bass note again. Then I'm going to go to the seventh fret with my third finger on both the third string and the second string. Then you can leave your first finger barred, or you can kind of keep moving it back and forth between there. Same thing is going to happen when we move it to B. Only this time, my first finger is going to be planted at the 7th fret 6th string. There's my bar chord. Kind of a nice way to visualize it is to visualize that bar chord. Go 7th fret on the 6th string, 7th fret on the 3rd and 2nd string. Hammer my 2nd finger on the 8th fret on the 3rd string. Hit that bass note again. Bar my 3rd finger on the 9th fret on both the 3rd string and 2nd string. And there we go. There's kind of my first example as a kind of country style lick. Now for the Motown movements, we're going to be thinking of essentially the same couple of chords, only I'm going to be adding another triad onto it. So it's going to be very similar to what we just did for the country, but I'm going to be adding one other triad to it. Okay, so here's the first example. Okay, now I'm starting out very much like what I did for the country, which is the country example, which is my root note first, so this is going to be an A on the 5th fret, 5th string, and again, I'm visualizing that 6th string bar chord right there. I'm going to be planting my first finger on 3 strings now, the 4th string, 3rd string, and 2nd string. Now I'm going to be hammering my 2nd finger on that 6th fret on the 3rd string. Now I'm going to be barring my 3rd finger now on the 7th fret, 4th, 3rd, and 2nd string. This is going to be almost like an A over D chord. So my D chord is the actual chord that I'm playing, but my root note is still the same. Again, these are kind of like riffs. So the chord names will change just so it's clear on what triad I'm using, but at the same time, this will all work over just kind of like a static A groove. Okay, so I had that first chord, second chord. Now I'm going to be replacing my 3rd finger with my 1st finger so I can hammer on this other triad, which is going to be a G triad. My 2nd finger is going to be on the second string, eighth fret. My first finger is going to be on that seventh fret, third string, and my third finger is going to be the ninth fret, fourth string. I'm just going to take off my hammer on and just going to play that seventh fret on the third or fourth, third, and second string right there. So there it is in A. Hammer on. That kind of D sort of triad, G triad, and then go back to that D triad. Now to move up to B, I just had to move my first finger to the 7th fret, 6th string, and then move my first finger down to the 7th fret on the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd. Hammer on my 2nd finger on the 3rd string, 8th fret now. My 3rd finger is going to be barred on the 9th fret, 4th, 3rd, and 2nd string. And then I'm going to be hammering on my 2nd finger on the 10th fret, 2nd string, and my 3rd finger on the 11th fret, 4th string, while my 1st finger is still on the 9th fret, 3rd string. And then take it off. Now, what's neat about those triads is that you can place them in any order and they'll still sound cool. So here's another example of using the same triads, but now I'm just going to be placing them in a different order. Here what I'm doing is I'm back at A, so my first finger, I'm kind of envisioning this major bar chord right here. My first finger is going to be on the root note. Now my first finger is going to be moving up to that D triad right there on the 7th fret, 4th, 3rd, and 2nd string, hammering on that G triad right there, which is my 2nd finger on the 8th fret, my 3rd finger on the 9th fret, and now I'm going to be taking them off. Just my seventh fret on those three strings right there, replacing that first finger with my third finger, and then hitting my first finger on the fifth fret, third string up to the sixth fret on the third string. Kind of that little hammer on right there. And here's one more example of the same triads, just in a different order. Now here is my first finger's on that root note, and I'm going to be hammering on my first finger on the 5th fret across 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings, up to the 2nd finger, hammering on the 3rd string, 6th fret for that major 3rd right there. I'm going to be placing my 3rd finger or 1st finger on that 7th fret on those 3 strings too, 4th, 3rd, and 2nd. And now I'm just going to be placing, not hammering on, my 2nd finger for that G-shaped triad on the 8th fret, my 3rd finger on the 9th fret, 4th string, and then going back to where my 1st finger is barred on the 5th fret. As you can see, there's a lot of different combinations that you can do with these triads, and since we've been tying them to bar chords, you can place them in any key and over any chord. If you like this video, be sure to like, subscribe, and share. And if you have any comments, please leave them in the comment section below. Thank you.